But if you feel that, okay, maybe you're just going through like a life change problem, maybe a marital problem, maybe, you know, just adjusting to a new situation. Maybe it's not that it's not affecting your physical parameters that much. It's not started affecting your sleep, not started affecting your appetite, your concentration. Then maybe you'd want to go to a psychologist first or someone who's doing psychotherapy as well. There are lots of psychiatrists who are also doing psychotherapy. A lot of the big psychiatrists also focus on psychotherapy, and a lot of the big psychiatrists also have a psychotherapist attached. So they'd be like, okay, maybe you don't need medicines and you can go to the psychotherapist. So sometimes that perspective can be taken in, you know, and getting as you said, that getting the correct help for where you are is what is paramount.
Yes, that's right. I guess it's understanding what the entry point is and not being afraid of the entry point, knowing that it's there to help you, not to harm you, that it's going to give you a template that will help you build for the future. We have a question where someone says, what are the symptoms of generalized anxiety disorder that would enable someone to seek help? I mean, if we say 40% of people have some level on the spectrum, how far do we have to get on the spectrum before we say, okay, now is the point that we actually need help?
So in my OPD, I have this one subsidized OPD where I'm following just the hardcore psychiatry model where I can only see patients for 15 minutes because, you know, there's that many patients. And you wouldn't believe that most of the, we call it GAD, generalized anxiety disorder patients, are referred to us by other doctors because they usually manifest with physical symptoms. They just think that the worry is a part of their life. They don't even consider that that's something that should be taken into account. And a lot of doctors can understand, they use the term functional overday. That means that, okay, someone comes to you with a backache, all right? But you know, you do an MRI or you do a scan, you do the test and you realize, okay, there may be a disc, there may be a strain, but the pain seems to be very disproportionate to the problem that we're seeing. So the symptoms of generalized anxiety disorder, the first one, of course, is the psychological symptom. That is that someone tends to worry about all things with no specific focus. And there's this always... what you call this fear of negative consequences. So when anything happens, it'll be like, this will go wrong. This could go wrong. So I call it red flag thinking, just to make it easy. Yes. Everything is a red flag. All right.
Yes.
And then that causes physical problems. The acute ones could be things like palpitations, hands and legs start shivering. They feel like this tightness in their chest or breathlessness, not to the level of a panic attack. But it's just more constant, you know, there's just this constant. Yes. And then because your body is at attention all the time, your muscles are engaged. So you end up with these aches and pains. So things like headaches, neck aches, back aches, you know, some people complain of like this, you know, this kind of tingling sensation and in their extremities because those muscles are just like contracted all the time. You know, and then a lot of them come to us through the GI doctors. So they might come with like irritable bowel. They might come with chronic gastritis or what we call acidity or, you know, so those are the kind of presentations we get for generalized anxiety disorder. And then, you know, they're sent to us because, you know, the standard like antacids and the painkillers aren't doing a good enough job. And a lot of times people are so, like, if you go to a general physician, they won't even tell you they've started you off on an anti-anxiety. They'll just be like, oh, this is for the pain. And you're just on an anti-anxiety medication, you know, for that. Yeah. Because there's so much stigma about going to a doctor. And GAD is so common that it can even be treated at a family doctor level.
Yes. Yeah. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.